In this illustration, we'll analyze a liquid in a long W tube. Here, the figure shows a W tube in which a liquid is filled and its four columns A, B, C, and D are kept at different temperatures, and temperatures are also mentioned here. It is saying the height of B and C are equal at 49 cm and the other columns A and D are open to atmosphere, in which liquid height are 52.8 and 51 cm respectively. It is saying if the temperatures are given here, we are required to find the coefficient of cubical expansion of liquid. So in this particular situation, we can write as liquid is at rest, we use Pascal's pressure equation from A to D as, in the situation here we can write at point A pressure is P atmosphere. At the bottom of A, pressure can be written as its height is 52.8 multiplied by density of liquid at 95 degrees multiplied by G. Then if we move up here at horizontal column, the pressure remains same. If we move up, our pressure will be minus 49 multiplied by density at 5 degrees centigrade multiplied by G. And again, pressure along the horizontal level remains same. If we come down, it is plus 49 multiplied by density at 95 degrees multiplied by G. Then again, minus. If we move up, this 51 multiplied by density at 5 degrees multiplied by G is equals to P atmospheric. So we have written the pressure equation from point A to D along the path where the liquid is filled. Here P atmosphere gets cancelled out and the value of G also gets cancelled out, and we can use as rho at 95 degrees can be written as rho at 5 degrees divided by 1 plus gamma multiplied by 90. That relation we use, it implies we are getting 52.8 multiplied by rho 5 degrees divided by 1 plus gamma 90 minus 49 multiplied by rho at 5 degrees. Here I am also cancelling the value of G throughout the equation. So this minus 49 multiplied by rho at 5 degrees divided by 1 plus gamma multiplied by 90 minus, this term will be positive, minus this 51 multiplied by rho at 5 degrees, and this should be equals to 0. Here rho at 5 degrees also gets cancelled out, and if you simplify this equation, it will come out to be 101.8 is equals to 100 multiplied by 1 plus gamma times 90. Further on simplifying, the value of gamma will get here, and this 1 by 90 multiplied by 101.8 by 100 minus 1, which is finally giving us numerically this 2 into 10 to power minus 4 degrees centigrade inverse. That is the result of this problem.